The Philippine government adds 9 more projects to its pipeline under the public-private partnership scheme. The National Economic and Development Authority says these will focus on health and waste management with a price tag of 65 billion pesos. The new projects are out of the 143 PPP undertakings in the pipeline as of July. The Marcos administration's massive infrastructure program is valued at 9.5 trillion pesos.
The Philippine Securities and Exchange Commission launches an initiative to boost efforts to achieve the country's sustainable development goals. Let's get more details on that from Jackie Pascual, who now joins us on the line. Hi, Jackie. Go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Securities and Exchange Commission, or SEC, has launched the Sustainable Enterprise Collaboration Network, or the ESEC Nature, to bring together companies and the government to accelerate sustainable practices in the business sector. The new campaign seeks to link corporations, government agencies, and civil society organizations to deepen the corporate sector's participation in sustainability initiatives to achieve the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. These companies and groups are asked to share their best practices to others and work to ensure the ethical and responsible conduct of business operations. SEC Chairperson Emilio Aquino said the businesses must think of sustainable practices to help the planet and not just simply focus on profits. Aquino also said that they will begin with the major corporations first, admitting that it will be more difficult for small and medium-sized enterprises to hire sustainability officers. But the goal, he said, is for all businesses to implement sustainable practices in the long run. SEC will also share sustainable tips and advice to all the businesses registered with them via email blast and social media posts. He added that pushing for sustainable practices, which include a shift to digitalization, will have a significant impact in improving the state of the capital markets and the economy in general. And that's later, Stanley, back to you.
All right, thank you so much, Jackie Pascual.
SM Investments explores new geothermal energy sources. That confirmation made in a stock exchange disclosure Monday. SMIC says its unit, Philippine Geothermal Production Company, will put up new project concession sites in the next 5 to 7 years. This would be in 6 areas from the Cordilleras, Cagayan Valley, and Bicol region. The undertaking will seek to increase the company's capacity to 400 megawatts and help the country's 40% renewable energy mix goal by 2040. Next, supply deal signed. Apo Cement of Cemex Philippines tapped Semirara's retail electricity arm to supply power to its plant facilities in Naga and Cebu. The agreement between Apo Cement and Sem Calacares Corporation lasts only until December this year.